I grew up in Anson County, Wadesboro, North Carolina. My childhood was filled with playing the piano for church and doing plays. Anytime there was a play, I was always getting involved with those. Well, I started acting when I was about 6 years old. There was a play in Wadesboro, North Carolina, and Marlene Richardson, she said, "You'll be great for this part." And there was only one line to the part. She would always get on me about that one line. She would always say, "You got to get that line right. You got to have the feeling. You got to feel it. You're not feeling it." And because the line, I believe, was, "My mama ain't got no washing machine." So I would get on stage and I would say, "My mama ain't got no washing machine." She said, "Huh? What did you say? What was that?" And I said, "My mama ain't got no washing machine." But she says, "No, you gotta feel it. My mama ain't got no washing machine. You know, feel it. Put some emotion into it." So she got on me about that line. And then later on, when my career progressed as an adult, and I was doing a lot of big things back in the day, I saw her at one of my shows. And I said, "You know, I got into this thing because of you. You got on me so hard about one line." And I was like, "What was so important about that line?" And she said, "I did that because that one line in general, gets you the part." And so I learned so much from that, because it is about the presentation and how you present yourself in the world that actually advances you and gets you to the next level. So you have to always remember that some things may not seem significant to you at the moment, but they help you grow. The biggest question I get for people is, do you get nervous? To be honest, I don't get nervous anymore. I focus on what I'm there to do, which I'm there to entertain people. If I'm doing a comedy show, I'm there to make people laugh. If I am playing the piano, I'm there to entertain you and get into your emotional state to where you can feel the music and you can feel the nuances of where I'm moving in the music. My career, I have portrayed several characters. I've played an old lady named Miss Minnie for many years. Miss Minnie opened up for Natalie Cole, who has passed on, but she was an international artist, secular artist. I've opened up for several gospel artists. I performed with Evelyn Turner, Teenage G, opened up for Dorothy Norwood, Sensational Nightingales. Just to name a few. I've been a part of major state conferences. And then I've also played a character named Deacon Eugene. And Deacon Eugene, I mean, he is hilarious. That's my latest character. There's no limit to what part I will play or take on. I'm just interested to see where my career goes next and what part I may be playing. The funnest ones for me is playing someone that makes you laugh, of course. And I've been able to do that. Even with the cop, I was able to make people laugh, and that makes me feel great. This word means to fully become the part that you are portraying. So when you think about verisimilitude, it's basically said, if I am casted for a movie, it's a big movie, and they want me to play a monster, I'm going to be so believable in being that monster that people actually think I'm a real monster. They don't know the difference between me acting and me actually being a monster. If I am going out there to play a spider, then I am going to be the best spider you've ever seen. So that goes back to when I first started acting as a child with Marlene Richardson, and how she told me, you got to get that line right. You got to feel it. You got to have the emotion. This goes back to that, because you have to fully be in character to the point where people don't know the difference between Will and the actual character that I'm portraying. Another important word that I want to discuss with you is coding. And it's something very valuable to learn about coding, just from the aspect, not only the aspect of acting, but from the aspect of life in general. Coding is when I say, I don't talk the same way to my boss as I do my friends. It's basically saying there's a different way I present myself. And life is all about presentation. It's all about who is able to best present themselves, who's able to articulate the best, who's able to show up and shine. So coding is very important word to learn, coding. So I'm going to give you an example of coding. So when I see my homeboys, I'm like, what up, dog? What's going on? But when I come to work, I'm like, hello, sir. How are you doing today? So great to see you. And so I feel like that's a part of acting in a way, because it's not, you have to turn it on and off, right? And there are some people that say, you know what? I'm just going to be me. And you can be you and still be able to code. You just have to know the difference of what's acceptable. There's a term that says, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. So if I see everybody else at my job and they're wearing uniform, that means I need to be in uniform as well. If you want to succeed in life, if you want to succeed in theater or whatever you're doing, just remember that there is a code for everything. There's a code for every environment. There's a code for every situation on how you are to present yourself. Also look at presentation. On what you're doing, what you're wearing, how you're carrying yourself. It's gonna help you in the future be a better person.
Don't rush, slow touch, grind on white. I can go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust.
So sometimes when I'm at home, I like to go through just years of things that I've done. I could go on all day. I could go on and on and on and on about the people that I met, the people that I've worked with, the opportunities that I've had, the lessons that I've learned. I could do that all day. But I just wanted to be quite transparent with you and letting you know that one of the greatest things, the greatest moments of my life was receiving this. You may recognize those colors. And receiving this, and I have some more to receive later on. Everything's not gonna always go the way that you want it to go, but these are very valuable to me. These are the most valuable pieces of documents that I have in my home, are my high school diploma and my college degree. Just remember that you're working toward getting this. It may seem small, to some it may seem insignificant, but I will tell you that it's very valuable. It actually showcases that you got some sense. It showcases that you are a person who can finish what you started. It shows that you have potential. And then if you go further, whether you go to the military or whatever you do in life, and you get something else, that just adds on to it, and you keep adding to it, and you keep adding to it, and it just builds you up to one day you're just up in the clouds and you're on top of the world. Hey, oh. In the next phase of my life, the next big thing I want to do, I want to go back to school, I want to finish my master's, and I want to get further into the entertainment industry. What you're going to do in the future has an impact on all of us, all right? And I want to be the one to say, that kid came from my hometown, and now I see them on TV, and I see them doing big things. I want to be able to say that. I want to be able to go back and you say, you know what? I saw a video that you put out for a lunch and learn when I was in the fourth, fifth grade, whatever. I want you to say that and say, you know, that really inspired me, and I'm able to be who I am because of that. So you all go out, be your best self, do the best you can do, excel, achieve, all right? The sky's the limit, and you can reach for the stars, all right? I love you, Anson County, Morven Elementary. Peace. Putting it in my stroll, I'll be high-stepping y'all, letting the joy